potential of this become simply x tau. X tau it is for ST minus S. Now this to be integrated with respect to t. Okay. Now let us consider this integral. Once this is evaluated at infinity, this term goes to 0. And when it is integrated at 0 minus, fine, t becomes 0 minus. So 0 minus to 0, this integral becomes again 0. So this becomes now let us consider this. We have to further see what is this integral. This is to be evaluated at say 0. The problem here is, let us define this one set is the transform as ys. Then what is the one set is the transform of this? 0 minus infinity minus infinity to tau dx tau d tau, it is for minus s to d tau. Now this is one sided Laplace transform. So that part of the signal which fails in negative time domain, that will not contribute to Laplace transform. This will be given 0 because this is valid only in positive time domain. So let us decompose in two parts. First, which belongs to the negative time domain, and other which belongs to positive time domain. So 0 minus to infinity. For negative time domain, this will be this. Now, this is the portion of the signal which corresponds to negative time domain, and integration is in positive time domain. So, this is not going to contribute anything. This will get rejected by the unilateral Laplace transform, and this will turn out to be 0. The other part is 0 minus to infinity integral 0 to t x tau d tau, it is for minus s to d t. This would be 0. Please see carefully. This signal corresponds to negative time domain and this is positive time domain. The signal in negative time domain, which corresponds to negative time domain, cannot be summed up continuously in positive time domain, and thereby this is 0. Now let us see what happens. This we have to integrate this integral. So this becomes, say, the first function into the integral of this. So this becomes 0 to t x tau d tau, this is the first function, into integral of this. This becomes a limit at which it is to be evaluated is 0 minus 10 50. Now minus differential coefficient of this, which becomes integral of differential coefficient of this. So if I differentiate, this becomes x tau, and it is from minus s t divided by minus s into t tau. Now let us see, what is this? If I, it will have some function now. If I evaluate at infinity, this becomes 0 because of this factor. And if I evaluate at 0 minus, integral of 0 to 0 minus, what will happen to this? This will be 0. So this term is going to make the thing 0, and this will be what? This is defined minus minus plus x of s by s, and this gives you the initial condition, right? At t equal to minus infinity, this becomes 0, and at t minus infinity, this becomes 0. So that is how it contributes. Now, next thing which is generally asked, if one side is Laplace transform of a signal x in x of s, then what would be the one side is Laplace transform of second derivative of x? This is unilateral Laplace transform. For doing this, let us apply unilateral Laplace transform definition of unilateral Laplace transform of this signal. So signal here is d2 dt square x of t raised to minus st dt. This is from unilateral Laplace transform. Now we have to integrate this integral. Let us take this as first function, this as second function. So this becomes first function into integral of this. The second derivative is integral. Integral will be the first derivative. That means d by dt of x t. And this is to be evaluated as 0 minus infinity. Now, differential coefficient of first minus of differential coefficient of first. That means this. Into integral of this. Now let's try to find out what is this. So this becomes e raised power minus st d by dt x t. The relation is at 0 minus infinity. This minus minus become plus. Now this again, let's take this as first function and this as second function. So first function e minus st into integral of this, this becomes x t, and whole is to be evaluated at 0 minus 20 minus differential coefficient of this and integral of this. That means x t e raised power minus st dt 0 minus 20. Now let us see what does it become. At t equal to infinity, this term goes to 0. So this becomes 0. At t equal to 0 minus, this becomes 1 and this becomes x dash 0 and with a minus sign. Okay? Expression of this function at this limit minus expression of this at this limit. So that's why this minus sign. Now let's see what happens. This is minus minus plus multiplied by s. So this becomes s square, and this is defined to be x of s. Then let's see what happens to this term. Related at infinity, this becomes 0, this becomes 0. Your latent 0, this becomes 1 and this becomes x sub 0. So this becomes s x 0. So we can rewrite this expression in a Carnot form, s square x of s minus s x 0 minus minus x prime, this indicates the derivative, first derivative of this at 0 minus. So this becomes the unilateral Laplace transform of this becomes x square x of s minus s 0 minus, then x first derivative at 0 minus. Now you can use this relation along with the previous information to solve any differential equation which involve initial conditions. You can apply differential equation of second order. For higher order, you have to find out what is the unilateral transform of higher order derivatives, and you can apply this method. Now, one more thing which we'll like to mention here, there are two theorems in Laplace transform. One is called initial theorem. Initial value theorem, which states that the value of a function at x 0 plus, that means x must be causal, this is equal to limit s tends to infinity s of x. That means if you know the Laplace transform of any signal x t, it should be of course causal. You can find this initial value by evaluating this limit at s tends to infinity. Like that, you have got final value theorem. Final value theorem, which states the final value of the signal x t, and if you want to find out the final value, you have to look for the steady state response. That means, what is the value of signal when t tends to infinity? Steady state value of the signal t tends to infinity. This must be limit s tends to 0 s of x. These are the two useful theorems to find out the initial value of the signal and final value. With this, I take Laplace transform as complete if time permits. Then we'll be doing some more problems on it. The counterpart of Laplace transform in discrete time signal is called Z transform. So Z transform is applied on discrete time signal. As in case of Laplace transform, we have got two type of Z transform also, say two-sided or bilateral Z transform and one-sided Z transform. So let us start our discussion from two-sided Z transform. The defining equation is that if I have got a signal, discrete time signal xn, then xn multiplied by z raised to power minus n, and this particular expression is sum in the entire time form. Now, this is defined as xn. is called bilateral jet transform. Bilateral jet transform. Bilateral because it covers entire time domain. I want to clear this term bilateral. This is 0. This is discrete time axis. This goes to infinity. And this side, this goes to minus 1. It's bilateral. This is one side, positive time domain, this is negative time domain. That is why it is called bilateral. At times, it is also called two sided jet transform. This is one side, positive time domain, this is other side, negative time domain. Now, how FZ has come? Let us view it in a different way. And that will help you to find the jet transform, form the defining equation without doing much computation. Here, x is a function of L. The exponent of g is minus n. N and this minus n, they are equal and opposite. So when they are equal and opposite, z replaces n and you get xz. But xz will exist only when this infinite summation converges. Here, the convergence is divided by, is given by g raised to minus n. Fine. The factor which is responsible for convergence is g raised to minus 1. Z here is a complex plane. So, the set of those values of g for which this infinite summation converges is called its region of convergence. The set of those values of z for which the above infinite series converges is called its region of convergence. It is abbreviated as ROC, region of convergence. Now, as in case of Laplace transform, any expression in XZ must accompany with it is ROC. If you fail to specify ROC with XZ, then you won't be able to get back the signal action uniquely. This will give a dubious solution. So, you find the Z transform of a signal, then in addition to the expression XZ, you must specify its ROC. If you don't do it, then you cannot get back the signal uniquely. That is needed. To illustrate this point, let us consider a signal x1n, which is a raised to n given, and try to find out this two-sided jet transform. So, this two-sided jet transform, let us define it by x1z. This becomes n equal to minus infinity to infinity. For xn, it is x1n, it becomes a raised for n, un, g of minus n. Now let us apply the definition of un. Un is a step function which is 1, 0 when n is greater than equal to 0 and 0 when n is less than 0. So if I apply the definition of un, from here, this summation limit change it, and now summation starts at n equal to 0, goes to infinity. Then this becomes 1. Once this becomes 1, I am combining these two terms, then I get e raised to a, tm minus 1 raised to n. Be sure that you have understood it. Okay. Now you'll find that in finite GP, it is infinite GP, geometrical progression, GP. This first term being corresponds to n equal to 0. If n equal to 0, this becomes 1. So first term is 1 and common ratio. N equal to 1, e j raised to power minus 1 to 1, and then n equal to 2. So common ratio becomes this. Now we can sum up this series, and the sum will be 1 upon 1 minus a g of minus 1, provided the common ratio is the mod of common ratio is less than 1. So the sum of this series become this only and only when a g of minus 1 is less than 1. That means minus c is greater than minus a. I multiplied by mod of g both sides. So thereby this becomes mod a, this becomes mod z. Mod z greater than a. I have written it in this way. Now this is ROC, region of convergence. This infinite series will converge to this only when mod z is greater than this. So this is the set of values of z which, if satisfied, then this infinite series converges to this. Let us show the convergence in a G plane. Let's have a G plane.